grab a chair or sit in the floor, just like, pillows that we can, like, over there.
Sorry.
Yes. So the idea is that, I summoned a few community leaders that are going to be presenting. Each of them is going to have 5 minutes to talk about the work that they are doing at the local level, or not. And then I have a few questions prepared, and I'm going to go over them with them. But then if the questions also speak to you and you would like to share your experience, I would love to hear that as well. And if you have questions to ask our panelists, that will also be welcome. So I think, let's see. Let's give a couple more minutes to see Verena.
Joy is going to go and get
yes.
Joy is going to go and call.
Huh?
Joy has gone to go and call.
Ah, okay. Cool.
Sure. That she feels some pressure.
Yes.
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 So busy.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Can you really mind sitting there? Okay, great. So welcome everyone. As I was saying in the invitation, this is a conversation that is following up on a conversation series that I started in March in the Wikimedia Movement. The conversation series goal is to understand what is the experience that a woman has in the movement, where are the challenges and where are the opportunities for development, and the idea is also to connect and to get to know each other better, as it has stemmed from the first three conversations I hosted in March. The conversations themselves were a good spot for women to meet, so I thought I could do this again here. Thank you for joining us, and maybe if we start with May. What I was saying, introduce yourself, talk a little bit about the work that you're doing.
Sure. So my name is May Hashem, I'm from Egypt, and I'm a co-founder for the Egyptian User Group and Wiki Women. And recently, like 2 years ago, I started a new partnership between Wikimedia and the UN Women. Our project name is Her Story. I've been like 5 years dedicated for the Wiki Women and the gender gap knowledge. I talk more about her story and what I've been doing there. We started with editing articles about Wikipedia to narrow the gender gap, and then we moved on to go to more of topics other than the female profiles. We wrote about the health problems related to women, problems that faced women more, and plenty of other issues. That's briefly what I do. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Erina Mukuta, I come from Uganda. I'm a co-founder of the Uganda Wikimedia User Group. I've worked on projects since 2014, ranging from Musha Takes Wiki, using open resource tools for education with Internet Society Uganda. Worked with schools to translate Luganda articles, and recently this year we formed a user group just to have some sense of community. I'm the only woman in the user group, and this year we're doing a project called Wiki Labs Women, so I hope by the end of this project that will change.
My name is Stella Ceci Agui. I'm the operations, events, and logistics person for Open Foundation West Africa, which activities to reach out through open movements to other West African sub-regions, and also to extend open education and digitization programs to be able to preserve cultural and heritage for educational purposes. So we've done quite a lot of projects. We've done Wiki Loves Africa, we've done Wiki Loves Women with Hair, we've done Wiki Loves Monuments, we've done Wiki Needs Girls, we've done Summer Open School, we've done Creative Commons. We've actually done a lot of projects. Yeah, that's
Hi everyone, I'm Isla. I'm from Cape Town, so welcome all of you to here. I started working on, it's all Yolanda's fault, I started working on Wikimedia projects back from 2011 and have, by starting to work on the Wiki Africa movement, and it became apparent that when we were working on, initially it was a GLAM, we worked on a GLAM project, and it became apparent that we had to really start right from the beginning and get a whole load, activate communities and users across Africa by creating projects around that. So we created Wiki Loves Africa, which I hope you've all heard of, and Wiki Loves Women, which is a very intense program, and Kamusha Takes Wiki as well. And so it's so fabulous for me to see everyone here, but also that it became so important to bridge not only the content gap on about Africa, but also the gender and the contribution gap. So both the contributor gap from Africa is huge in comparison to other regions. And if we could activate people at the same time, so women and men together, without there being an imbalance from the beginning, that was to me like a number one thing we want to do. And so that's why Wiki Loves Women is specifically focused on that, but it's not about just activating women writers, it's about also activating gender sensitized men too. So,
yes. Cool, thank you very much. So the first question I have is, in your personal journey as a Wikipedian or Wikimedian, have you ever encountered any boundaries? And if you can think of one to share.
So, to give me some time thinking about that?
Yes.
Like to pick the right time, the right one. I think what we encountered that when we asked for to be present or to be visible, people, they, why you shouldn't be there, or why you should be visible, you're already visible. They can't see the gap. There's a huge knowledge gap, and unfortunately not with all of people, they understand that how crucial it is. So to spread awareness of what you're doing and to spread awareness of the importance of the free knowledge or the open access websites is it's more of a cultural problem. Yeah, so that's one of the biggest boundaries.
Okay, I would say that it has to do with content, especially when it comes to issues of women on the internet. And in Ghana for that matter, it's so limited that you find it difficult creating articles on very notable women. You virtually have nothing on them sometimes on those of these things. That's one. The second would have to be on the affordability of data and actually getting very consistent networks that give you very good data to be able to work with.
I think for me, like Meg, the cultural bias of what does this woman have to say to us, or what does she bring? But even if someone doesn't say it, sometimes the way they treat you, it shows that it's like you're subhuman, but I think they don't even notice they're doing some of these things. And of course, like she said, coverage about women. I recall when we had that WikiGap event and we just sat down to brainstorm ladies, let's write articles, but just searching online of like the top notable women that had no articles, we had no published work, not even in a newspaper, nothing that can be recognized on Wikipedia. So we had an event and only one article was created.
I think it's also, sometimes it's internal. I think that I had a very interesting discussion in Toronto with Creative Commons community, and it was very similar position like this. There was a lot of women there, and it was led by Kelsey Merkley, who some of you might know. And she basically said, like, do we allow ourselves to be leaders as women? And most of us go kind of like, reluctantly.
I'm not trying.
And I think it's So it seems to be, you know, as in, oh, somebody else is going to take that position, or somebody else is going to do that work, or, and especially there's like this assumption that if you're working in computers or in, or working on a computer, not even in computers, but working on a computer, therefore you must, should be male, and therefore that's male domain. And so when we started Wiki Loves Women, many of the people who we had, not had to because we chose to work with them, but many of the people we worked with were men, purely because we, there weren't any. At the time there was one other person in Ghana who was female, and it was, she still is female, sorry. but it just was impossible to find that. Now through these projects there are, you know, we've got lovely ladies from Ghana here.
Yes.
Exactly, three. And there are others back at home.
Yes.
So it is also about then, and we had a discussion about taking leadership roles,
yeah,
and making sure that you are putting yourself forward as well for those positions and not waiting for people to find you worthy of them. And I think in many ways, in many societies in Africa, we're still in that kind of position where women are seen as being, you know, not, shouldn't take leadership roles or shouldn't be seen to be taking leadership roles. And so I think it's up to us to challenge those.
I think I'm a testimony of that, because when we started Kumusha Takes Wiki and we went back home and Ayla kept saying, start the group. And I bring up all these guys, I'm like, start the group. Yeah, and like, I like that she encouraged me, because initially I was like,
of it,
just
don't
want to be at the front.
Yeah.
It's true. I also attested that, because before Indaba in Accra,
yeah,
she was like, Felix, why do you think like this girl do this? Like, try delegate roles to them for them to also be able to do something. And it actually has helped some of us today, not just with doing Wiki stuff, but doing other things that we do outside. Joy has created her own foundation, just being active and learning other things from this. So
yeah.
So actually, the next question is connected to some of the things that you were saying. So if we could expand a little bit on that and thinking about the position that you have today, I was wondering, what has made you feel empowered to lead or to get into this role?
I'd say that there were lots of initiatives and lots of movements that were, like, for example, let's give an example of the Wiki Women initiative. We heard about it in the Middle East, and I started the first Wiki Women in the Middle East. It was so inspiring for us to do that, especially that we have a huge gap, even more than what they have. So initiatives. Also, there is another thing that I would like to talk about. There, I don't know if you're all familiar with or not, the Wiki Gap campaign that was run. It was with the Swedish embassy,
yeah,
and they made it in 40 countries, not only Africa or not only in the Arab world, and they were like asking people to edit about women. So for me, what empowers me, these initiatives, these people who gives me like the space to speak, the power to stand up and say, let's join us. And they give you like the also the power to empower others. So if I'm empowered somehow, so that's why, or if I empower people, that's why I'm empowered one day. So yeah, eventually that's what like inspires me a lot when I see everyone working, everyone sharing.
Can you speak up a little bit? It's difficult to hear the words.
So I was talking about that if I feel like if I empower others or help organizing things, that there is always someone who empowers me, whether institutions, media, initiatives that you all do is amazing. So this is inspiring for me to continue to do other things.
Okay. I also say that knowing that there's a need that I can feel, like there's a gap that I can also assist with to ensure that especially for notable issues of content on women, it's out there, people can read it. The history of Ghana is out there. The history of Africa, the voice of Africa is being heard. through me or through any other person who is volunteering. Volunteering is very, very important. I'll give you an example. We had Wikimate Girls, which was targeted at students, secondary school students, just girls. There were a lot of them, and so now some of them are still editing Wikipedia. Some still call, send you messages that they need help with this, they need help with that, so can you please assist them with this kind of things? Yes, it gives you that sense of fulfillment that you have actually impacted, you have done something for someone that the person appreciates, and would not just be something that the person will need for today, but to be something that would help the person after now, after today, in the future, that will be there for future generations to come and meet. They will also impact on others as they go along the way. So yeah, that for me gives me that feeling of empowerment.
I think for me, what empowers me is other women.
I think for me, what empowers me is other women, being in touch with other women, hearing their stories. It's more like when you hear someone else's experience and you're like, oh, okay, so I can do that, so this happened. So I like that, being in touch with other women. It empowers me.
Yeah.
But from my point of view, it's been exactly that, that actually not even just being in touch with, but being absolutely collaborating completely with. So with Yolanda and with Florence, I've literally, it has completely transformed the work that we've done, the way that I work, how things happen, and to have that kind of like that ability, the respect, to be able to respect each other and work in that way, I think has been amazing. And because, and also across all sorts of different, distances, yeah, and the diversity and the way that it works, I think also has allowed for a whole complexity that I think, we wouldn't have otherwise.
Did you have a mentor? Is there someone that you feel like you have learned a lot from? Anyone that made you feel empowered to step into this organizing role?
Yeah, definitely. I would say the volunteers. They teach you a lot. Like, the more you deal with volunteers, the more you know about how great you do, and the more values. I say you even stick more to what you're doing, and you get new ideas. So they're like, yeah, they're the mentor. They're the biggest mentor ever. Yes, so volunteers.
Okay, for me, I think I'll start with the two gentlemen that actually introduced me to Wikipedia. I was just doing my own thing, and Raphael calls and says, Stella, there is this context gap on women. And so far, it's actually just the two of us. They're actually guys who actually started working with this. So I thought, okay, why don't I give this a shot? Let me try and see. And because after all, there is a need to do something, so I joined, and since then they've actually been a very motivating factor. And they're like, look, I see you are very good with organizing stuff, you can do events, logistics, why don't you do it, why don't you try your hands out with this? And they leave the roles out there for you. They actually give you the room to explore, try it out. If you don't do well, then they're like, oh, okay, you should have done this rather this way, and it will help you. Yeah, so I think these two gentlemen actually are Felix Nati and Raphael Becci, are actually the two people who actually have pushed me out there to be who I am today.
Yeah, I think also for me, it's people who have pushed me. That is Isla and Florence, always pushing me into gently.
Like, something I'm not comfortable, and they're like, no, do it. And then when you do it, you're like, oh, I can do it. So yeah, they've been mentors to me, whether they know it or not, yeah.
From my point of view, I think it's just everyday experience. I think every person that I've interacted with, every person who, and it's about, I think it's also about being open to learning constantly. So even when situations go bad, that to try and make sure that you learn from those experiences. And I think that's what, where we are as kind of a brave new world. So I think it's, we have to try and soak up the bad and the good and see and, you know, try and shift our way towards the best of us.
So, do you feel like Wikipedia's policies and written rules describe the way you work with others on everyday life?
No.
This would be the challenge that we were talking about.
I haven't read all the policies. Like, who has? How many people have read all the policies? I think it's, yeah, it's like guidelines, like good guidelines, yes.
In every society, there are norms and rules that actually guide you, or else they become chaos. So yeah, Liz, it's a guide. Yeah, I would rather say it's a guide to, you know, doing, ensuring you do things well and engaging with people correctly. Yeah, so yeah, partially I would say, because I also haven't read all the policies anyway. So yes, I would say, like, with the ones I know of, yes, I can do
I've just heard policies. But I always just see how everyone, that's the policy I know, how everyone interacts, how things go. It's really mouth, how people interact with each other.
Yeah, probably the same. Like, I try to cope with what we have, because things do go. So.
I think the best one to take out is the be bold one. You know, that you, that's, and then the assume good faith. I think those are the two, those are the two policies I'm going to stick by.
And I'm going to share a data point here. Between 2013 and 2017, we've noticed more women stepping into leadership positions across Wikimedia organizations. The percentage of female representatives grew from 20% to 27% in that time frame. I wanted to gather your thoughts on what do you think bring this change to be, or brought this change forward, and what do you think made this possible?
So, why these changes? I think it's, we are more aware of the problems that we have, so things are tackled in a better way. I'm 5 years old Wikipedian. I can't call myself an old Wikipedian, but when I joined the community, I was lucky to see, like, well, we have a gender gap issue. We have X, Y, Z. So I came in a time, the perfect timing, where I saw all the problems and then had to choose. Okay, I'll fix that. I will do that. So I think, yeah, being like having a strategy, what to do, that helped a lot.
I would say that probably people's passion and the passion to, you know, do things is beginning to be there, and being bold, like, now people are actually putting themselves out there to say, okay, this is something we should do, this is something I should do. So I think that is maybe one of the reasons why there's an increase in the, and maybe because of the trainings that people are also getting, events they're attending, it's becoming an eye-opener for people to say, okay, these are the challenges we have and that we need to fix it. So I think that is one of the reasons why there's that issue.
I think I really agree with her. The initiatives that have taken place between that time, you could see they're geared in that direction, so they have made a difference.
Yeah, I think it was also just the acknowledgement on the side of the community that started everything else. I think by openly, not necessarily, I mean, it became, you know, like a sweeping curve.